welcome you all to the new session of the Laplace transform. So in this session, we shall be discussing about the unit step function and how the Laplace transform is carried on the unit step functions. So let us first understand what is unit step function. So the unit step function is a function in which it is represented by u of t minus of a. So the representation of the unit step function is u t minus a. So the unit, in the unit we have the initial letter, that is u. So the function is also defined by u of t minus a. So why it is defined as t minus a and not ut? Because here at this a point, there is a step. So you can see we have taken this graph. This is the t-axis and this is the a point on the t-axis. So what you observe in this graph, that this at this a point, we have that the function ut minus a has one value. See here that this ut minus a is defined then that when the t value is less than a, when t is less than a at this portion, when t is less than a, then the function ut minus a is zero. And when t is greater than equivalent to, then ut minus a takes the value as one. So this is the unit step function and the a is always greater than equal to zero. So you can see again that the unit step function is defined as ut minus a, which is equal to zero when t is less than a. You can see here that t is less than a. So the unit step function value is zero. And when t is greater than a, when t is greater than a, at this point, the unit step function value is taken. This is why the function is called the unit step function. U is due to the unit value and at a value, it takes a step of one. So that is why it is called the unit step function. So I hope that you have understood how to define a unit step function. So unit step function ut minus a is zero when t is less than a and it will be one when t is greater than or equal to a and a is always a positive value. So now let us find out how to calculate the Laplace of such unit step function. Now let's calculate the Laplace transform of unit step function. So Laplace transform of our ut minus a, that the Laplace transform of the unit function is given by e to the power minus as by s. So let's see how it takes the shape. So we have the Laplace of ut minus a applying the basic definition of our Laplace transform. So it is 0 to infinity to the power minus ft dt. So instead of ft, now we have substituted for ft as ut minus a. So we know that ut minus a is defined as how? For ut minus a, we know that when t is less than a means from 0 to infinity, sorry, from 0 to a, when the t value takes 0 to a value, the function has 0 value. And when the t has value from a to infinity, it takes the value as 1. So making all these substitutions, we can break up the interval in two parts. So we have the interval, first interval is from 0 to a. So the first integral is from 0 to a e to the power minus st. And for this interval or for this 0 to a limits, the ut minus a has the value of 0. And for the second integral, we have the limits from a to infinity and ut minus a has a value of 1. So we have substituted the 0 value and a 1 value and we shall accordingly solve it. So the first integral, since it is multiplied by 0, so the first integral value is equivalent to 0. So this is equivalent to 0. So we are left out with only the second integral. So now we shall solve this integral. So it is e to the power minus st by minus s and the limits are from a to infinity. So when we substitute the limits, we will get e to the power minus infinity minus of minus s, which is equivalent to plus e to the power minus as by s. And we know that e to the power minus infinity is 0. So that is why we are just left out with e to the power minus as by s. And in this way, we are able to calculate the Laplace of the function ut minus a, which is equal to e to the power minus as by s. So always remember that the Laplace of the unit step function is e to the power minus as by s. Second shifting theorem is when the Laplace is calculated for the function and the function is multiplied by u of t minus of a. So we have that Laplace of f of t is f of s, and the Laplace of f t minus a u t minus a is equal to e to the power minus as into f of s. So what is there? It is there that when the function, that is the unit step function, is multiplied with a function in the same form as that of the unit step function, that is ft also takes a nature shape of ft minus a. So when the same f function is multiplied with the unit step function, then the answer is f of s, and f of s is multiplied by e to the power minus as. So such type of result is called as the second shifting theorem. So we have that Laplace of ft minus a ut minus a. So again, we apply the basic definition. So we have 0 to infinity e to the power minus st, and in place of f of t, now we put our ft as ft minus a ut minus a into dt. So again, we shall break our intervals into two parts because the unit step function is defined for two intervals. So one integral is from 0 to a, and the second integral is from a to infinity. For 0 to a, ut minus a has the value of 0. And for a to infinity, the ut minus a has the value of 1. So since this is multiplied by 0, so the first integral is equal to 0, and this gets vanished. So we are left out with only the second integral, and we have the result, that is a to infinity e to the power minus st f of t minus a dt. Now we make a substitution, that where we have the function t minus a, so we substitute this t minus a as w. So we are writing, or we are substituting, w is equal to t minus a. So if we differentiate, as a is a constant number, so dw will be equal to dt. And in the limits, we have that t have the limits a to infinity. So if we put a here, if t is equal to a, then a minus a will be 0. So when t is tending to a, then w is tending to 0. And for the upper limit of t, where t tends to infinity, so infinity minus of a will be infinity. So hence, we can say that when t tends to infinity, w is also tending to infinity. So that's why we get the result. And making all these changes, we get 0 to infinity to the power minus s times, because here it was t, st. So t will be equal to w plus a. You can see here, this a will get on this side and it will change the sign. So we will have t will be equal to w plus a. So we have made the substitution. We get e to the power minus s w plus a. And it was f of t minus a. So for t minus a, we had already substituted w. So we get f of w, and dt is equal to dw. Now here we can break our exponential in two parts, and e to the power minus as is constant. It is taken out because the integral is carried over w. So e to the power minus as comes out of the integral. We have 0 to infinity e to the power minus sw fw dw. So this is nothing but the basic definition over the variable w, which can also be written as e to the power minus as f of s. So you can see we have come out with the result that the Laplace of the ft minus a ut minus a is e to the power minus as of fs. So always remember that if We have Laplace of ut minus a, it is e to the power minus as by s. And if we have Laplace of ft minus a, ut minus a, it is e to the power minus as of fs. So let's calculate another theorem related to the unit step function. So this theorem is that if we want to calculate the Laplace of the ft ut minus a. So here the function ft is f of t ut minus a. It is not taking the shape of ft minus a. Haven't be in it be ft minus a, then we would have applied the second shifting theorem. So now it is ft multiplied by ut minus a. So the Laplace transform of such a function is e to the power minus as Laplace of f of t plus a. That means that the variable t is now shifted with t minus a. We have to make the changes of the function as f of t plus a, and then we have to apply the Laplace. So let's see the proof of the theorem. So we have Laplace of ft ut minus a. So applying the basic definition, we have 0 to infinity e to the power minus st ft ut minus a. Again, we shall break our intervals in two parts. First integral has the limits from 0 to a, and the second has the limits from a to infinity. For 0 to a, ut minus a has value 0, and for a to infinity, ut minus a has the value 1. And because the first integral has 0, so the first integral value is equivalent to 0. So this vanishes out, and we have only the second integral, which is a to infinity to the power minus st ft. Substitution, since our ut minus a was there, so we make a substitution that this t minus a is equivalent to u. So we make the substitution of t minus a equal to u. Since a is a constant value, so we get dt is equal to du, and we know that the limits of t are from a to infinity. So when t value is equivalent to a, or t is tending to a, then you can see that if we put t equal to a, then a minus a is equal to 0. So u tends to 0. And when t is tending to infinity, when t is taking the value of infinity, so infinity minus a is again infinity. So u also tends to infinity. So making all these changes in the equation, we get that the limits are changed from 0 to infinity. It is e to the power minus s u plus a into f of u plus a du. Now again, e to the power minus as term in this exponential is a constant because the integration is carried over the u variable. So e to the power minus as is taken out of the integral. So we have 0 to infinity to the power minus su f of u plus a du, which is nothing but the Laplace of f of u plus a. So we can make a change that instead of u variable, we can write it as a t variable. Since it is applicable for all the variables, so we are writing the expression as e to the power minus as Laplace of f of t plus a. So you can see that we have got our result. So Laplace of ft ut minus a is e to the power minus as Laplace of ft plus a. Now the function is modified in such a way that wherever there is a t, we have to change t by t plus a, and then we have to apply the Laplace. So this will be clear once we see the problems related to the unit step functions. So let's have a quick recap of the unit step function. So we can see here that the unit step function is defined as ut minus a, where ut minus a is 0 to when t is taking the value less than a, and it is having a value 1 when t is greater than equal to a. So this is the graph of the unit step function. So the Laplace function is applied upon the unit step function. So Laplace of ut minus a is e to the power minus as by s. And the second shifting theorem says that the Laplace of ft minus a, ut minus a is e to the power minus as f of s. And the Laplace of ft applied on ut minus a is e to the power minus as Laplace of function t plus a, where t is modified as t plus a, and then we have to apply the Laplace. So in all these, we can see here that e to the power minus as is always there. You can see e to the power as is always multiplied with the f of s. Now let's see some of the problems related to the unit step function. So here is the problem that we have to first express our function. The function is defined as f of t is 10 when t is less than 2 and it is equal to 5 when t is greater than equal to 2. So we have this function, we have to express in terms of unit function, and when we express it, then we have to apply the Laplace transform. So our ft is 10 when t is less than 2 and it is 5 when t is greater than equal to 2. So we can express this 10 as 10 plus 0 and express the 5 as 10 minus a 5, which makes no difference. Now you can see there is a 10 number which is common in both the upper and the lower values of t. So we can take this 10 common and we can express this as 10 plus 0 to minus 5, where 0 is value is for t less than 2 and it is minus 5 when it is t is greater than equal to 2. So that when we add the 10, we will have to add both for t less than 2 and for t greater than 2, such that we again come out with 10 and 5 value. Now what we can say, we can take out the minus 5 common. So we can express this as 10 minus 5, 0 to 1, t less than 2 and t greater than 2. So this 0 and 1, this is our unit step function. The unit step function is carried for the a value equal to 2. So here a is 2 value for the unit value, unit step function. So this part can be expressed as ut minus a. So for ut minus a, we have written as ut minus of 2. So our function is expressed as, ft is expressed as 10 minus 5 ut minus 2. If you had expressed this expression as 5 plus 5, you could have written as 5 plus 5 and 5 minus of 0. Then you would have come out to be 5 plus 5 and there would be 1 0. So it would have been a unit step function in the opposite direction. So this would not have solved our problem. So that is why always remember that it takes the value for 0 where t is less than a and it takes a value of 1 where t is greater than equivalent to 2. So choose your variables or choose your quantities accordingly so that you get as 0, 1 for t less than a and 1 for t greater than a. So that is why we have expressed this 10, 5 as 10 minus 5 ut minus 2. Now since we have expressed our function step terms of unit step function, we can apply the Laplace on this. So it is Laplace of 10 minus 5 ut minus 2. So we can apply the linearity property. So it is 10 Laplace 1 minus 5 times Laplace of ut minus 2. And we know that Laplace of ut minus a is e to the power minus as. And this a value is this 2 value. So we can have the result as 10 by s, because Laplace of 1 is 1 by s. So 10 by s minus 5 times e to the power minus 2s by s, because a is 2 here. So we get the result for the following question. Function in terms of unit step function, and then we have to calculate its Laplace transform. So the function is ft is m value for t lying between 1 to 2 and it is 0 value for t greater than equal to 2. So as you have this function, so we have m 0, where m is having the value when t is lying between 1 to 2 and it is 0 for t greater than equal to 2. So we take this m outside. So we can write this as m times 1 when the t value is lying 1 to 2 and it is 0 when t is greater than equal to 2. So you can see that this is the graph of the question. So the t value is 1 here and t is 2 here. So ft is taking a value of 1 here. So you can see that at this point it is taking a step at 1 point, and again the step is lying only for the interval of 1 to 2, and then again it is taking a value of 0. So for such a function, we have expressed this as m of ut minus 1 minus of ut minus 2. So how did this come for the graph of ut minus 1 minus ut minus 2? Let us take a very quick thing to see how it takes the shape. If we had ut minus 1 graph for ut minus 1, if this is the 1 value, so if I want to draw a graph for ut minus 1, so at this 1 point, before this 1 point, it would have taken the value 0, and after 1, everywhere it would be a step value. So I shaded a yellow color. You can see I have shaded it a yellow color. Now I take a different pen, and this is for 2 value. If I want to draw it for 2, so the unit step function for 2 would be had been from here. So this red blue portion would be for the area for ut minus 2. So now what we want, our question was under the consideration that t is lying between 1 to 2 and it is taking a height of 1. You can see here for t lying between 1 to 2, it is taking a value of 1. So when we subtract ut minus 1 and ut minus 2, then the portion which would come under the consideration would be this portion. So this will be the portion which will be the resultant of ut minus 1 minus of ut minus 2. So the portion would have been this region, that is lying between from 1 to 2. So that is why this is expressed as ut minus of 1 minus of ut minus 2. So in this way, you can express any of your function as, if the t is lying between 2 limits, 1 to 2, so it is always written as ut minus the lower value minus ut minus the upper value. So the lower value is 1 here, so we have written ut minus 1, and the upper value of the t interval is 2, so we have written ut minus 2. Again, I am showing you the same. For 1, this is the green dashed arrow slanting lines is the region for ut minus 1, and for ut minus 2, the region is for the red slanting lines. So when you subtract the region of ut minus 1 minus ut minus 2, so it is this shaded portion. So the shaded portion, the blue shaded region, is the region of ut minus 1, which is the area under our consideration. So we can express the function as m times ut minus 1 minus of ut minus of 2. So now we have to apply the Laplace on such a function. So Laplace of m times ut minus 1 minus of ut minus 2. So it is m into Laplace of ut minus 1 minus m times Laplace of ut minus 2. And we know that Laplace of the unit step function is e to the power minus as by s. So in this case, our a is 1, and in this case, our a is 2. So we get the result as m times e to the power minus 1s by s minus m times e to the power minus 2s by s. So I hope that you have understood the problem and how to solve the question. Another problem of the unit step function. So here is our function ft, where ft is expressed as t minus 1, where t is lying between 1 to 2, and it has the value of 3 minus t when t is lying between 2 to 3. So first we have to express this function in terms of unit step function, and again we have to apply the Laplace transform. So this is our function. So now you have understood in the previous problem that when the t is lying between 2 limits, so we always write it as the function ft, which is take the value t minus 1, multiplied by ut minus the lower value of the interval minus ut minus of 2, which is the upper value of the interval. So it is t minus 1 ut minus 1 minus ut minus 2. Similarly, for 3 minus 2, we can write this as 3 minus t times ut minus 2 minus of ut minus 3. So it is again, now we multiply this t minus 1, these two terms. You can multiply with these two terms, and similarly you can multiply 3 minus t with these two unit step functions. So you get t minus 1 ut minus 1 minus t minus 1 ut minus 2, and 3 minus t ut minus 2 and t minus 3 u of t minus 3. Now we shall collect the terms for the various unit step functions. So we have only one term for ut minus 1, which is t minus 1 ut minus 1, and we have two terms, two coefficients for ut minus 2. So taking ut minus 2 common, we get, and minus sign also common, we have t minus 1 minus 3 plus t. Here there was a positive sign associated with 3 minus t, so it changes its sign to get minus 3 plus t. And ut minus 3 has a coefficient of t minus 3. So solving the middle portion, t minus 1 minus 3 plus t, you get 2t minus 4. So we have taken 2 common. So we get t minus 1 ut minus 1 minus 2 times t minus 2 ut minus 2 plus t minus 3 ut minus 3. So now we have to apply the Laplace on such a function. So Laplace of t minus 1 ut minus 1 minus 2 times Laplace of t minus 2 ut minus 2 plus Laplace of t minus 3 ut minus 3. Now you can see that we have to apply the second shifting theorem, which is Laplace of ft minus a ut minus a, because the function is in the same form as expressed in the unit step function. So it is e to the power minus as times f of s, means we have to apply the Laplace of the function, and e to the power minus as is multiplied with the f of s. So it is nothing. So we can see here that our a is 1 because the unit step function ut minus 1 is there. So for the first Laplace, we get e to the power minus as, which is 1s, and the function t is t. So the function is t, so we have to apply the Laplace over t. Similarly, in this part, you can see that a is now 2, so it takes the form e to the power minus 2s, and the Laplace is carried over t. Similarly, for the third Laplace portion, we have a value 3, so it is e to the power minus 3s, Laplace is to be carried on t. So we know that the Laplace of t is nothing but 1 by s square. So what you get, the answer you get as e to the power minus s by s square minus 2 times e to the power minus 2s by s square and e to the power minus 3s by s square. So 1 by s square is common, you get e to the power minus s minus 2 times e to the power minus 2s plus e to the power minus 3s. So this is the final result, and we get our answer. So let's discuss about the next problem of the unit step function. So here the function is that it is having the value of 0 when t is lying between 0 to a. It is taking a value of t minus a when the t is lying between 0 to b. And it is taking the value of b minus a for t greater than b. We have to express such a function in terms of unit step function, and hence we have to find the Laplace transform. So the function is this function. You can see you have this function. So you can directly express it in terms of the unit step function. So since it is zero value, so it is zero, nothing has to be taken into account. So we start with the second part, that is t minus a, and it is lying between the interval a to b. So we can write this as t minus a ut minus a minus of ut minus b. And for t greater than b, it is having a height of b minus a, as is you can see here that when the t was having a value of 0 to a, it was taking a value of 0. When the t had a value of a, in the second part, when we put here t equal to a, so a minus a will be 0. So you can see here that at a point, the value is 0. The function has the value 0. when you put the t value equal to b, so when you put this is at b, so it will take a value of b minus a. So if this is a point of b minus a, so at this b point the value of function is b minus a. So from a to b it would take a height, a line like this, it would increase, and after b, when you can see that after that t is greater than b, it always has a function value of b minus a. So it is at a height of b minus a. So that is why we have written this as t minus a ut minus a minus ut minus b plus b minus a times ut minus of b. Now multiplying this t minus a with ut minus a and ut minus b, so we get these two terms, and now we shall collect the coefficients of ut minus a and ut minus b. There are two coefficients of ut minus of b, so we have t minus a minus of b plus a, so which gives out the result of t minus a ut minus a, and it is here t minus b. So there is a correction, so it is t minus of b times ut minus b. So we have Laplace of t minus a ut minus a and Laplace of t minus b ut minus b, because we had to apply on the function which was expressed in the unit step function. So you can see here again, this is the second shifting theorem. So second shifting theorem is Laplace of ft minus a ut minus a is e to the power minus as f of s. So the function, the f of s is applied on the function. So Laplace is applied on this t variable. It is not applied upon t minus a. So it is Laplace of t. So we can say here that it is e to the power minus as Laplace of t minus e to the power minus bs Laplace of t. Because in this one, the b is your exponential. So it is e to the power minus bs Laplace t. And Laplace t is 1 by s square. So you get the result as e to the power minus as by s square minus e to the power minus bs by s square. So this is the result. So let us now discuss another problem of the unit step function. So here we have the function as sine 2t, where t is lying between 6 pi to 8 pi, and it is having a value of 0 for t greater than 8 pi. Now we have to express our function in terms of unit step function, and then we have to find the Laplace. So this is our function. So we can express this as sine 2t u of t minus 6 pi minus u of t minus of 8 pi. So this is, now we can apply the Laplace on the function. So we have applied the linearity property. So it is Laplace of sine 2t u t minus 6 pi and Laplace of sine 2t u of t minus 8 pi. Now you can see it is not of the type that sine 2t minus 6 pi into ut minus 6 pi. Then it would we have applied the second shifting theorem. But it is now the case of Laplace ft ut minus a, which is equal to e to the power minus as Laplace of f of t plus a. So here a in the first, a is 6 pi. So it comes out to be e to the power minus of 6 pi s Laplace sine 2 into t plus 6 pi. Because when we apply the Laplace on ft ut minus a, then we have to change our function t by t plus a. So in the function, our ft is sine 2t. So we replace our t by t plus 6 pi. So please note this step, that now the Laplace is carried on the function sine 2t. The t is replaced by t plus a, and a is here 6 pi. So the equation gets the result as e to the power minus 6 pi s Laplace of sine 2 t plus 6 pi. And we know that sine of 2n pi plus theta is sine theta, because 2n pi is the period, 2 pi is the period of the sine function. So sine theta takes the value same as sine of 2 pi plus theta or sine 4 pi plus theta or anything. So sine of 2t plus 12 pi will be equal to sine of 2t. So it is e to the power minus 6 pi s Laplace of sine 2t. And Laplace of sine 2t is nothing but 2 upon s square plus 4. So it is e to the power minus 6 pi s 2 upon s square plus 4. Let us again see this part. When we apply the Laplace of sine 2t ut minus 8 pi. Again, this is same as this form, that is ft ut minus a. So again, we have to change our function by t plus a. So it is Laplace sine 2t plus 8 pi. Wherever there is a t, you change the t by t plus a. So it is e to the power minus as, it is e to the power minus 8 pi s, Laplace of sine 2t plus 8 pi. So it is e to the power minus 8 pi s. Again, sine 2t plus 16 pi is equivalent to sine of sine 2 theta. So it is Laplace of sine 2t, and again sine 2t Laplace is 2 upon s square plus 4. So you can see this 2 upon s square plus 4 is common in both the parts. So you get 2 upon s square plus 4 into e to the power minus 6 pi s minus of e to the power minus of 8 pi s. So in this way, you have to apply the theorem.